Hello, I'm Dr. Jaren Riley and I specialize in pediatric orthopedic surgery. I'm here today to speak about femoroacetabular impingement, or FAI, and adolescent hip pain. In this video, we'll cover anatomy, how FAI presents, long-term consequences of FAI, and what popping around the hip means. The hip is a ball and socket joint. The ball is formed by the upper end of the femur. The socket is formed by the pelvis. Both ball and socket are covered by hyaline cartilage. This is an extremely low friction tissue which allows smooth, painless joint motion. One more structure, called the labrum, is a tough rubber-like ring around the socket which functions like a gasket. It creates a seal for the ball and socket joint, increasing its stability. As long as the shape of the ball and socket are a perfect match, you can run, jump, and dance painlessly. But if there is even a subtle mismatch between the ball and socket shapes, the bony edges of the joint will bang into each other or impinge, resulting in damage to the bone, cartilage, and labrum. The bony deformity can be on the ball side of the joint, called a cam deformity, or the socket side of the joint, called a pincer deformity. Both can be in a combined deformity. After years of impingement, the hip becomes very painful. When the labrum tears, the cartilage degenerates, creating juvenile arthritis, and physical performance is difficult, if not impossible, to maintain. Hip pain due to impingement is called femoroacetabular impingement, or FAI. In the short term, FAI causes pain that results in loss of ability to play sports or even perform daily activities. New research is showing that in the long term, it causes degenerative joint disease, or DJD, or arthritis, leading to the need for early joint replacement. Most active people with FAI develop pain in their late 20s or early 30s. However, high-performance young athletes, dancers, gymnasts, and so on, are at risk to damage the hip at a much earlier age. Pain usually begins in the groin area and will progress to affect the muscles that help stabilize the hip until the pain is felt on the inside of the hip, in front, and even in the lower back. The pain is worsened with activities that cause the bones to impinge. Popping and locking of the joint may develop. Treatment begins with non-surgical measures, and activities need to be modified to avoid the actions that cause the pain. Anti-inflammatory medications such as ibuprofen or naproxen may be used. Physical therapy will also be utilized to strengthen the muscles around the hip and the core muscles. If non-surgical treatment fails, or if the labrum and cartilage damage is advanced, surgery is an option. The goals of surgery are to relieve pain and prolong the life of the hip joint. Most FAI can be treated with arthroscopic surgery, meaning a small camera is passed into the joint, along with the tools to change the hip's anatomy. Cam and pincer deformities can be reshaped until the two sides match and the impingement is eliminated. Labral tears can be repaired. Sometimes severe deformities require open surgery. Both methods are safe and effective at accomplishing the goals of pain relief and joint preservation. Thank you for taking the time to learn about femoroacetabular impingement and adolescent hip pain. If you have any questions or concerns, we invite you to make an appointment with one of our doctors to assess your child. When treated early, children who develop FAI can lead normal, active lives. We encourage you to follow these guidelines and schedule an appointment if you suspect any problems.